Hi everyone, this is S. Lakshmanachari, working as Assistant Professor in the EC Department, Institute of Aeronautical Engineering. Today we are going to interface a 4x4 matrix keypad with 8051 microcontroller. So for this, we are interfacing both the 4x4 matrix keypad and LCD display. So whenever if you press any key on the 4x4 matrix keypad, then that number will be displayed on the LCD screen.
Open Kale Microvision 4 tool. Click on Project. Select New Microvision Project for creating a new project. So create a folder on the desktop. Give the folder name. And give the file name. And here different types of vendors will appear here. So these are SR Labs, Aeroflex UTMC, Ultium, Analog Devices, Anchor Chips. So these are all the different These are all different manufacturers of the microcontrollers. So in this I am selecting NXP, it is founded by the Philips. To see all the different microcontrollers available under this vendor, you drop down by click on plus symbol. So go to the bottom and select P89V51RD2. After selecting the desired microcontroller, click on OK and copy startup.a51 to project folder and add files to project. So this is a startup file. So when we are writing the program in the C language, this startup file is required. And when we are writing the program using assembly language, this startup file is not required. Click on S to add or copy. So that startup file added to your project. And now open the editor by click on File, New. So write the program. So this is a program. So this is a hardware interfacing of the 4x4 matrix keypad with 8051. So this is a hardware connections of the 4x4 matrix keypad with 8051 microcontroller. So whenever we are pressing any key on this keypad, the same number it will display on the LCD screen. So total this keypad, it contains total 4 rows and 4 columns. So the row names R1, R2, R3, R4 and columns are C1, C2, C3, C4. So this keypad we are connecting to the port 1 and LCD screen we are connecting data lines of LCD module we are connecting to the port 2. And similarly the control pins of LCD display we are connecting to the P 3.0, 3.1 and 3.2 respectively. So this is a 4x4 matrix keypad. So this keypad, it contains total 4 rows and 4 columns. In first row, one terminal of all the 4 push buttons are connected to together. So in first row, if you take row 1, so one terminal of all the push buttons are connected to the row 1 and the remaining terminals are connected to the other columns. So we are getting 8 terminals to connect with a microcontroller. So 4 rows and 4 columns. So total 8 terminals are coming. So these 8 terminals we are connecting to the microcontroller port. So whenever any button is pressed, we need to get the location of the button. Means the corresponding row and column number, once we get the location of the button, we can print the character accordingly. So now the question is, how to get the location of the pressed button? So I am going to explain by using the below steps. So first step is first we have to made all the rows to logic level 0 and all the columns to the logic level 1. And second one, whenever we press a button, column and row corresponding to that button gets shorted and makes the corresponding columns to logic level 0. Because that column becomes connected to the row, so which is at the logic level 0. So we get the column number, see main function. So this is a way of finding the column. So total 4 rows and 4 columns are there. So for all the rows, we are applying a logic low, logic 0. And for all the columns, we are applying a logic 1. So suppose if you press any key. So see here, suppose if you press this button, so this 0, the logic 0 applied at row 2 will appear at the column 3. Because of the pressing of this button, the row 2 and column 3 gets shorted. Okay, so if we get logic 0 at the column 3, that means the button which is connected to the row is pressed. So this is a way of finding the column number. And after that, now we need to find the row number. So we have created 4 functions corresponding to each column. Like if any button of column 1 is pressed, we call function row finder to find the row number. And step 4, in row finder 1 function, we reverse the logic levels. Means now all the rows are logic 1 and columns are 0. So in the previous one, when we are finding a column, we are applying all the rows to the logic 0 and all the columns to the logic 1. So now the row of pressed button should be 0 because it has become connected to the column whose button is pressed, and all the columns are at logic 0. So we have scanned all the rows for 0. So finding row. So for finding row, we have applied a logic 1 to all the rows and logic 0 to all the columns. So suppose if you press this button, so the button is a circle with a blue color. So when we press this button, so the logic 0 applied at column 3 will appear at the row 2. So that means, so the one of the button which is connected to the column, which is connected to the column 3, is pressed. Okay, so fifth step is whenever we find a row at logic 0, means that the row of pressed button. So now we have column number and row number. Now we have column number and row number, and we can print number of that button using LCD underscore data function. So the same procedure follows for every button press, and we are using while loop to continuously check whether button is pressed or not. So this is a program, keypad program. So first line is a header file. So ash include register 51.h. And after that, we are defining the port. Okay, we are defining the port for displaying LCD module. So ash define display underscore port P2. So the data lines from the LCD module, we are connecting to the port 2 of 8051 microcontroller. And similarly, the LCD module contains three control signals. So that are RS, and RWE. So RS is a register selection. So that bit is connecting to the P3.0. And read or write signal from the LCD module, we are connecting to the port 3.1, P3.1 of 8051 microcontroller. Similarly, enable pin, we are connecting to the P3.2. So these are the LCD connections. And coming to the keypad, so the keypad total, it contains four terminals. Total keypad contains total 8 terminals. So four rows and four columns. So row 1, row 2, row 3, row 4, and C1, C2, C3, C4. So total, the keypad contains 8 terminals. And we are writing the delay function. So void ms delay, unsigned int time. So we are taking two variables for generating delay. One is I and another one is j. So for I is equal to 0, I less than time, I plus plus. And for j equal to 0, j less than 1275, colon j plus plus. So it will generate a 1 millisecond delay. Next, void LCD command. So for displaying any data on the LCD, first we need to send commands to the LCD module. So for that, so display underscore port, so is equal to command. So that means first we will send the commands to display the data. And RS is equal to 0. When we are sending commands to the LCD module, the register selection bit is equal to 0. And read or write 0. So read or write pin, it is equal to 0 when we are sending commands to the LCD module. And enable pin is equal to 1. So first, to send a command, the enable pin should be high. And after that, we are providing a delay. And after that, we have to apply a logic 0 to the enable. So that means we have to apply a pulse. And after that, LCD data. So after sending commands, we are sending the data. So for that, the function void LCD underscore data, unsigned character, display underscore data. So display underscore port. So equal to the display underscore data. So that means we are sending the data to the port. And when you are sending data, the RS pin is equal to 1. So RS means register selection. And RW. When we are sending data, RW is equal to 0. And enable pin is equal to, initially it is we are applying logic 1. And after calling delay, we are applying logic 0. That means it will generate a pulse. So we are calling high. And after that, low. So that means it is a pulse. And void LCD initialization. So to display any data on the LCD screen, the LCD should initialize. So for that, we will pass different commands. So first command is the LCD underscore command 0x38. So this command is used for two lines and 5x7 matrix of the LCD. So we are using a 16 by 2 module, 16 by 2 LCD module. That means it contains two rows, and each row it can display 16 characters. So after sending every command, we are calling the delay function, and after that 0f, 0f. So 0f is for to turn the display on and cursor blinking on the LCD module. We are calling the delay function, and after that 01 to clear the screen. So suppose if previously it is showing any data, that will be clear by passing the command 01. And finally we are sending 81. So to bring cursor to the position 1 of line 1. So after that we are calling the delay. So this is a LCD initialization commands. So first we need to find the row. So which row of button is pressed. Okay. So void row underscore finder 1. So this is a program for the finding row 1. So initially for finding row, we need to apply a logic 1 to the all rows and a logic 0 to the all columns. Suppose if row 1 is equal to 0, so all the columns are 0, and suppose if R1 is equal to 0, so that means the 7 is pressed. And similarly, if the row 2 is equal to 0, if row 2 is equal to 0, that means the button 4 is pressed. And if R3 is equal to 0, this 1 button is pressed. And similarly, if R4 is equal to 0, this on button is pressed. So like that, we will check we will find all the rows. So this is for finding row 2. So same concept here. If R1 is equal to 0, so that means now we are checking this row 2. So if R1 is equal to 0, this button is pressed, 8. If R2 is equal to 0, that means here the 5 will display. Next 2, 0. So like that we will check all the rows. After that checking the column. So void main LCD initialization, and we are taking the while loop, and MS delay 30. So we are taking the delay 30 milliseconds because we have to press the button and release the button. After that only we have to press the another button. So that's why it takes some time for pressing and releasing the switch. So MS delay 30 milliseconds, and column 1, column 2, column 3, column 4 is equal to 1. That means we are checking the column. So the respective rows, all rows, we are initializing to the logic 0. So if C1 is equal to 0. Okay. So if C1 is equal to 0, that means the corresponding row we can find. So row finder 1. Else if C2 is equal to 0, then row finder 2. So like that we will check all the columns. So this is a program for interfacing keypad with 8051 microcontroller. So after writing program, we have to save, give the file name and extension .c, click on save, and add this C file to our project by right click on the source group, add existing files, click on the file and add.
Close this window and right click on the target, give the options.
On default it is showing 40 MHz crystal oscillator frequency. Now change it to 11.0592. Click on OK. So right click options, and also click on this output tab and check in this create hex file. So we need a hex file to verify the results in the hardware or by using the Proteus software. So click on OK. And now press click on Project, build the target.
So in this build output, it will show if any errors or warnings are there. So if no errors and warnings are there, then hex file will be created. So the hex file will be it will be shown in the folder where you have created. So you can see the hex file. So this is a hex file. So now we are going to upload this hex file into the Proteus software. So click on start, open the Proteus software. Click on new project. Give the file name. And browse the path. Click on new project. Next. Do not create a schematic. Create a schematic. So we need a schematic. And we do not require a PCB layout. So click on do not create a PCB layout. Next. So no firmware project. Create firmware. So when you are writing the program, we need to select the create firmware project. And family 8051. And controller 80C51. Compiler. Keil compiler we are using. Keil for 8051. Microcontroller. Click on next. Click on finish. So it will display a schematic. So here we are connecting a LCD module and a keypad. So take the keypad from the component mode. Click on this component mode and after that click on P. P means pick device. Here type the component name. Component or device name. Keypad. We want keypad. So keypad. So this is a keypad we are using for interfacing. Click on OK. So that keypad will appear here. So drop here. And after that select the LCD module. So LCD. Type LCD. And here the type of display we are using is a 16 by 2. That means two rows and each row it displays 16 characters. So click on OK and drop here. Okay. So the row 1, so this is the row 1, row 2, row 3, row 4. So row 1 we are connecting to the P1.7 and row 2 we are connecting to P1.6, row 3 1.5 and row 4 1.4 and similarly column 1 we are connecting to the 1.3, column 2 to the 1.2, column 3 we are connecting to P1.1 and column 4 to the P1.0. And after that we need to connect the LCD module. So LCD module. So the data lines, the D0 terminal from the LCD module connect to the P2.0. So see here, so the LCD, for displaying data, the LCD data lines we are connecting to the port 2. So D1 terminal I am connecting to the
P2.1, D2 to the P2.2, D3 to 2.3. So respectively, connect all the data lines to the port 2 of the 8051 microcontroller. And here, see the three control signals are there in 8051. So the control signals are RS, RW, E. So these are we are connecting to the, so the RS is connecting to 3.0, RW to the 3.1 and enable pin to the 3.2. So RS connecting to the 3.0 and RW to the P3.1 and enable pin to the P3.2. So now the connections are over. Okay, now load the hex file by double click on the microcontroller. So select the hex file and open. Click on OK. So now the hex file is loaded and run the program. So click on run. So if you press any key on this keypad, the same number will display on LCD module. Suppose if I press 7, so 7 is displaying, 8, 9, so divided by, so you can display any number by pressing on the keypad. Number 2, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So in this way we can display all the data.
So in this way we are interfacing the 4x4 matrix keypad with 8051 microcontroller. And similarly, whenever you press any key on the 4x4 matrix keypad, the same it will show on the LCD screen. So thank you.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.